Hi, this is Laura, your QuickBooks expert. Thanks for watching. Let me show you how exciting it is that we can now use client data review when working on-site, remoting into our client's file, or working in a hosted environment for those clients using QuickBooks Pro or Premier 2015 or newer. I'm in my client's Rock Castle Construction file, and they're using QuickBooks Pro, and I'm on-site working, but I would really like to use the client data review tools. So I have unlocked my accountant toolbox, as you have learned previously in this module, and I can choose to open a review, or I can choose to work individually. Perhaps I'm simply doing reclassification of transactions, or I'm writing off small balances on customer invoices. So there are some of the CDR tools that you can use individually without opening a formal review. Now I'm going to go ahead and open a review so you can see what it looks like. And again, I'm working on site, I'm working in a hosted file, or I'm working remote using Join Me or Log Me In or one of those other tools that are available. But I have unlocked my accountant toolbox in order to have access to this. But let's open up a review. When you begin your first review using client data review, you're asked to select a date range as well as a basis, either accrual or cash. Then CDR displays. Remember we talked about the wrench icon? Those are unique tools that are available only when you have access to client data review. You can customize the tools that are displayed. I mentioned earlier that if you had a client that, for example, doesn't need to file sales tax, you could simply turn off the view of sales tax for that particular client. Again, this change is only with the currently open file, not with other client files, because again, you're on site at the client's site. I'll turn that back on. You also can choose to modify your review. And as I've mentioned, you have to be logged in as external accountant in order to unlock the toolbox, which includes access to CDR. Each of the groups of tasks are arranged in some order as to the tasks that you would complete. So when you are reviewing the client's account balances, these are tasks that are pretty common, and so they're included automatically in that group. If you do not see a wrench icon, that indicates that that's a menu option that's either available in the client's file or it's available using your accountant software and does not require client data review. The individual tasks offer the ability to assign a status. So we can see here on the fixed asset items list changes, that review has been completed. Next to each task is the opportunity to write a note. So here we've had a new purchase of a new asset. We need to request additional documentation. There are also optional review notes. These review notes over in the box to the right can be transferred from one period review to another. Now in this example, I'm choosing to review an entire year. You may instead be doing a review for a month, or a quarter, or 6 months. You'll see that process as we work through the review. So customizing the client's data review tool is easy, keeping track of statuses as well as notes, as long as you have unlocked your access by logging in as an external accountant user. Let's go on to some other demonstrations of particular tools available here in client data review. Before I start this next demonstration, let me tell you that I am not going to be demonstrating each and every tool in client data review. This module includes a supplemental guide that will provide you much more detail on working with each of the individual tasks in client data review. but I want to pick up some of the more useful ones in this demonstration. So I want to start with a scenario. I told you earlier that we would be using a case study when we worked with client data review demonstration. So I'm going to use the example that you have simply been hired to do a quick analysis of the data in order to get a tax return, but you want to be as thorough as possible and still maintain your budget. One of the first tasks I'm going to recommend that you do is the troubleshoot prior account balances. So let me open that up and we can discuss what goes on in that particular task. In the troubleshoot prior account balances, QuickBooks is going to display off to the right in a column titled Balances in Clients File, which you see here, the balances that are present for the date range listed, which is appropriately 1 year before your current review period, which our review period is year 2018. And those are the balances in the clients file. How many times have you gone back into a client's file and your previously filed tax return balances have changed? A client deleted a transaction, added a transaction, modified a transaction, any one of a number of things can actually cause QuickBooks to see a difference in the balances that you used previously. Now, you learned in your original QuickBooks exam how to set a closing date and a password, and I would strongly recommend that you do that. But in the event that you didn't and balances have changed, this is a perfect tool to use. Now, notice presently, this is the first time we're using CDR Troubleshoot Prior Account Balances. Notice that there are no balances in the accountant's records. You can choose to either type the balances. Unfortunately, we're not able to copy and paste from Excel, but you could type the debit and credit balances, or if you prefer, it's really quite easy to click this Copy Balances. What that did is that entered the balances that are in the client's file presently for that date range. Now, that could be wrong, and you might need to go in through the balances and actually type over them, type the corrected amount. But let's say that you're getting this file back a year later, and let's do something the client might have been likely to do while you were not working in the file for that year. I'm actually going to make an error. You can learn a lot working with software by forcing an error into the system. So I'm going to go back here. Here's a rent check. Gosh, it's a cleared bank transaction, but don't our clients do this far too often? We're going to delete that reconciled transaction. Trust me, if you had set in the file a closing date and a closing date password, you either would have prevented this from happening or the user would have had to put in the password in order to make the change. You want a little tip? Here's my password for clients who engage me to help them get their books in order. My closing date password is Call Laura. Now, please don't let your clients use that. I don't want all those phone calls. But you would be surprised how many times I get that phone call or that email. I went to change X, Y, and Z, and I had to put in that password. So I'm thinking I should call you. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. Now, I've turned off some warnings in this sample file. You can also have a warning that would ask them to approve the fact that they're deleting a transaction. But let's go back to our troubleshoot account balances. And I'm going to go down here in the lower left and ask CDR to only show me accounts with different balances. And look at that. QuickBooks CDR Troubleshoot Prior Account Balances has recognized the accounts that are off simply from that transaction that was changed by the client. In the client's file, you'll actually be able to click on any one of these to actually see the detail, and you can add a column to see who made that change or who did that deletion in this case. It doesn't work as well in sample data, so I'm not going to click through it, but you try it in your client's file. So when you've come back a year later, QuickBooks would present to you, when you opened up the troubleshoot prior account balances, you would see the differences. I'm going to click in the lower right and view the suggested adjustment. QuickBooks knows the date to give the adjustment and the accounts to affect the change for, and it populates a memo that indicates it was a troubleshoot balances adjustment. You can accept it or you can change it. Another consideration that's discussed in the supplemental guide, if you have accounts receivable and accounts payable changes, those cannot be included in the same journal entry. You'll need to separate those out and determine the appropriate customers and/or vendors for those adjustments. But we know we've got to get the books to agree with the tax return if we're not going to file an amended return. So I'm going to accept this, but if your client does have their bank account reconciled and somehow this did work, having deleted it, let's see what we could do next. So I'm going to save and close that transaction, and QuickBooks is going to allow me to view a suggested reversing entry, or I could choose not to reverse it. And notice that it has selected the next date to reverse that transaction in the checking account. And I will tell you, when you go to do your bank reconciliation for the client, you should clear those two transactions. But notice now there are no differences. It was that easy to reconcile the current QuickBooks file with the tax return filed balances. So do make sure this is one of the first tools that you use, whether you are engaged for a quick, easy tax return, or whether you've been engaged for more of a troubleshooting deep dive into the client's file. Use Troubleshoot Prior Account Balances. The next time you get this file a year later, or whatever period you're looking at, these balances will remain in this particular window and cannot be changed, even if these balances change because clients have ignored modifying transactions in a period that you have locked. These will remain the same and will give you that differences column. Let's move on to another part of using the CDR tools that will make it efficient for you to work with your clients' files. Let's continue with the scenario that we've been engaged to do a quick tax return. Notice that we have marked the Troubleshoot Prior Account Balance is now completed. And let's start with the next task, Reclassify Transactions. Before I go there, let me tell you what type of effort this replaces. Normally, when reviewing a client's file, especially when we were on site without access to these accountant tools, we would review a profit and loss and other reports and drill down on the detail to see if the transactions are all properly coded to the right account. And then we would one by one click through them and fix them as needed. But there's a much easier way. In CDR, you have a client data review only tool titled Reclassify Transactions. Once that displays, because I am in a review period, my review period displays, but I could change that as needed, change the basis as needed, and decide if I want to look at expense accounts only, profit and loss accounts, which would include the revenue accounts, or balance sheet accounts. For this demonstration, I'm going to leave it as the expense accounts. Now, similar to what we were doing previously, one would simply just click through each of the accounts and review the information off to the right. Very similar to drilling down on the profit and loss. If when I'm looking at an account and I look at the transactions and I realize, well, look at that, they've charged an insurance bill to automobile fuel. That must have just been a mistake. It's very easy to fix. Simply place a check mark next to this one or any transaction that needs to be corrected. You can either drill into the transaction one by one, but it's very simple to go here to the account 2 in the bottom, and we're going to change this to insurance. and select Reclassify. Before I do that, if there were multiple Sargent Insurance in here mixed with others, you could choose just to view the Sargent Insurance vendors that are listed here. And now it would only show you those transactions for Sargent, would make it very easy to isolate individual transactions to a particular vendor. Now let me also show you the choices you have for transactions that are displayed. If it's a non-item based transaction, you can reclassify the to account. That means that you can only reclassify those transactions that are created using the expenses tab. That's the expenses tab on a check or the expenses tab on a bill. For item-based transactions, some of you might not be familiar, so let me just open that up to show you here. This is the expenses tab. These can easily have their account changed in CDR. Whereas the items tab, the only thing that you could reclassify would be the class. If there's class tracking or departmentalized income, that's the only item that can be reclassified in the reclassify transactions. You can choose to show the selected account, or if you searched for Sargent Insurance, you could choose all, and it would show you everywhere Sargent Insurance was assigned to within the date range listed on the left. And you optionally can choose to include journal entries in the transaction type. So if we're fixing this one here, we've assigned it to insurance, we will select reclassify. Now notice that it no longer displays in the fuel expense, it has been reclassified to the insurance expense account, just what we need it to do, and so much simpler than going transaction by transaction. Do know that if you are using CDR and your client has sent you an accountant's copy, when you send back the accountant's copy, there will be a PDF of all of these changes. Presently, I'm using it just on at the client site, remoted in or hosted, so there is not a separate PDF alone of just my changes. Let's continue by looking at some other unique tasks available with CDR. It would also be recommended when doing a tax return to use the working trial balance. From the working trial balance, you can view the beginning balances, which are now matched and reconciled with the previously filed tax return, drill down on any transactions for the current period, make adjusting entries and see them in the adjustments column, and see the account ending balance, as well as noting any work paper references. As adjustments are created, their effect on net income displays in the lower right. Simply click here to make your adjusting journal entries and even print to paper or PDF the review. Let's take a look. So QuickBooks does provide you with a working trial balance that you can print for your records and for the client's records. Maybe that's all you're engaged to do, but perhaps you have a more detailed engagement with the client to review a few more changes. The next group of tasks that we'll look at is in the Review List Changes group. This is unique. Only in CDR can we see changes made to accounts, items. Well, fixed asset items, we can also see those in Fixed Asset Manager, but changes to payroll items. The audit trail report, which is quite deep and detailed in the QuickBooks desktop product, still does not include counting changes to these particular lists. Let's take a close look by clicking through each one. So again, we're getting the file back after having perhaps not seen it for a year, and we can see that the client has added a money market account and the account type is bank. Perfect. So we can mark that as reviewed in the lower right. When we mark something as reviewed, future reviews will not display that item unless we purposely select the include reviewed items in the lower left. Notice it has an R next to it, meaning that in a prior review we had viewed that. Let's look at items that have changed. So it looks like they changed an item name and they changed the parent account. Well, nothing that really affects us, so we're going to go ahead and mark that as reviewed. You will also see later in this module, when you open the Manage Fixed Assets tool, it also will recognize new assets. But we can now see that there is a new asset, and we know we want to place a note to collect information from our client about that purchase. We'll mark that as reviewed as well. And the last item changes that are tracked, payroll items. So it looks like they changed their California unemployment rate, and I've confirmed that is the correct rate, so we can now mark that as reviewed. Then we can come back here and simply mark each of the statuses appropriately so we can keep track when we come in and out of a task if we have finished it, if it's in progress, or simply not applicable. Tracking review list changes is only available to be done in client data review. It's an excellent tool to use to track some rather important changes that our clients can make that can cause data issues. And this way we can see them right away and attend to any changes that need to be made. Thank you for joining me. We look forward to helping you with QuickBooks.